So the chapter 7, that is getting to know plants. Plants you can see everywhere, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Are these plants are looking like alike? Are these plants are
Some
looking alike?
of
Are these are same?
their
Are these are same? No. Even if you are sitting there, see, Altina can view the plants outside through her window. In the same way, you can also check it, right? If you are simply looking outside, there is, oh, Ashish is turning back and checking. Okay. So there also you can see a variety of plants.
Plants.
Variety of plants are there, right? See, some may be small, some may be big plant, some may be some of their leaves have different shape. Some of the flowers, some plants have different colored flowers. Sometimes some plants will bear some fruits, right? They don't
Yes,
have any flowers, but fruits will be present. In the same way, the plants, each one of the plant is differ from one another based on the character. So here let me show a picture first. Okay. If you can't see outside as you are attending the class, if you can't see it outside, you can see this one. Can you see this picture?
ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Is there any problem in this picture? After seeing the picture, Brisa went bounced back. Brisa, is it okay?
No, ma'am, I did not.
Okay. So here you can see a variety of pictures. Some are growing near to the ground, some are just above the ground, and some are growing much above the ground. No need to explain these all. I think you learn these all things in the smaller classes. Yes or no? Okay. Based on the characteristics, we can divide. Based on the characteristics of plants, we can divide the plants. Okay. So, anybody can tell me what are the groups, what are the classifications?
I'm like roots, stem.
They are all parts of plant. Root, stem, leaf, flowers, they are all parts of a plant. Based on the character.
Herbs and
Yeah,
herbs,
very good.
shrubs,
Herbs, shrubs, and
trees.
trees. You know it, right? Very good. Very good. So, in which class you learned about this? First and lower standard. So there the first introduce the words, names, herbs, shrubs, and trees. Three different types of plants. Okay, same thing. So shall I go to the go directly to that part?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
Yes, ma'am.
okay. So, classification of plants based on their characters. We can classify based on their characters. Okay, note down the point based on their character. We can see herbs, shrubs, and trees. Mainly three types. In the next class, we will learn some more about it. Okay, herbs, shrubs, and trees. These are the main three groups of plants based on their characters. Okay, so let me show you what are herbs. We can see the characteristics of herbs. Okay, we can see the characteristics of herbs. Can you see the board?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
Yes, ma'am.
Altina, can you tell me what is the name of that plant which it is? Which you can see it. Alchina? No. Siana, can you see the board? It is visible, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then tell me the name of this one plant.
Herb.
No, I want to ask, I want to get the name of the plant. Is it familiar? Is that plant?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So can you tell me the name of that? Don't know. Okay, Shravana is ready to say it. Yes.
Tulasi.
Yeah, Tulasi. Maybe we consider, Hindus consider this plant as holy, holy plant, right?
Yes, ma'am. Puja.
So, Sienna, what is the name of this plant?
See.
Tulsi. Okay, it is a medicinal plant. Nowadays, we can use it for, we can use it in the boiling water. We can put the some of the leaves of Tulsi plant in water, and if we boil it and if we drink that one, that also will increase the immunity of our body. Okay, so see, just compare this Tulsi with the man. Don't write it now, don't write anything, just and listen it. Okay, don't write anything. So I am going to compare this Tulsi plant with your jackfruit tree. Okay, so first thing, when we, Anna and Shravana, don't write it. Okay, when we compare this Tulsi plant with jackfruit, okay, how you will compare it? Sanya, Sanika.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, how you will compare this?
Ma'am, jackfruit has stones and thorns in that, and the Tulsi has...
I am not telling you to compare the fruits or both the plants. I just want to compare the plants.
Trees and herbs.
No, I did not introduce this word. Just compare these three, these two trees. Geetika.
Tulsi is small and the jackfruit tree is much bigger.
Yeah, size. Just we can, we don't know any scientific names or classification and all. Okay, just I told you to compare it. So first, when we say comparison, means we have to see the characteristics. Right? Whenever we want to compare, we should understand, we should know the characteristics. So here first, Geetika took the characteristics as size. Tulsi is a small plant and jackfruit is a big plant. Very good. Very good. Malavika, you are using virtual background and we are all seeing on it. Okay. But it will distract the class. So please remove it. Okay. And Ayan, is there any other comparison? Can you see any other characteristics for comparing Tulsi and this jackfruit? You are, see, in the last class, I saw you in the WhatsApp group. I saw your activity along with the plants. Very good. Congratulations. Okay. Beautiful flowers with, okay, very good. So I think you are the right person to ask this question. So which all other character? First, Geetika told it is size. Is there any other characteristic to compare?
Leaves.
Leaves. Okay, tell me, what about leaves? Yes.
Big leaves.
Okay, small leaves for the Tulsi and big leaves for the jackfruit. Okay, can you tell any other one? So, with this size, it is already told. Yes, who can say?
I'm Kenny.
Yes, Ravana. Yes.
Ma'am, jackfruit trees have fruits in it, but Tulsi don't.
Okay, then any notable difference? Notable difference?
Ma'am, can I say?
Somebody is, yes, Anna.
Ma'am, Tulsi is thin and jackfruit tree.
The stem. First we took the size. Then second we are taking the stem, character of stem. So Tulsi stem, it is very thin. If we just bend it, it will bend. So what about the jackfruit stem? It is very thick. If we use our force, can we bend that one?
No.
If it is there, means no need of any workers to cut the jackfruit trees. No, we ourselves can bend it and we can use it for furniture or other things. Okay, so it is not possible to bend it. Then any other thing?
Ma'am.
Yes, Ananta. Ananta Krishna.
Ma'am, Tulsi does not have a fruit, but
Okay, that it is told. Yeah, externally we can see the size, the stem. And one more thing.
Yes, can I say, ma'am?
Yes.
Can I say, ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, can I?
Yes, Risa.
Ma'am, Tulsi has a kind of.
Say it fast.
Huh. Ma'am, Tulsi has a kind of smell, but jackfruit doesn't have that. Like,
oh, smell. Jackfruit leaf also is having the smell. Okay, so let me share this one, characteristics of herbs. Okay, herbs are plants with green and tender stems, like Tulsi. Green and tender stems. Can you see it? Green and tender.
Yes.
Okay. So I am marking it, highlighting the point, green and tender stem. That also we can say it as non-woody stem. First listen, after that you can write. I will give time. Herbs are those plants with green and tender stems. That means non-woody stem. And next, we can easily bend its stem. Okay, we can easily bend its stem. Next one, usually shorter in height. Short in height. That is the other one. And the last one, that is what I am expecting. Few branches, when we compare Tulsi and jackfruit, which plant is having more branches? Which plant?
And jackfruit.
Yes, that is this. So few branches. So if we say the characteristics of Tulsi, his stem is very thin, green and tender. We can easily bend it, and it is short in height. When we say about the branches, it doesn't have much more branches, very few branches only. Okay, so trees having or plants having these all characteristics, we can call that type of plants as herbs. Okay, those plants which show these kind of characteristics, we can call these plants as herbs. Okay, not only the Tulsi. So many different types of plants are there that comes under the group herbs. Okay, so let me call Ananya Vijesh. Ananya, read the first point regarding the characteristics of herbs.
Plants with green and tender stems, non-woody stem.
Okay, enough. Next one, Ameya.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
We can easily bend its stem.
Okay, very good. Next one, Anna, read the third one.
Usually short in height.
Okay, and Ashish, last one.
Few branches.
Okay, so here in the first point, we are taking the character of the stem, how it is, hard or tender. In the next one also, we are taking the character of the stem. And in the third one, we are comparing the size. And in the fourth one, branching of stem. What is the mode of branching of stem? So, three characters we are referring here. Okay, let me stop sharing and ask me the question. Harriet, give me one characteristic of herbs. Don't read it from the note. Just remind it. Okay, remember this. Okay, think it and say it. I gave the clues.
Only have like few, only some branches.
Ah, very good. Okay, if we consider branches, it only have few. Sometimes no branches or sometimes very few branches. Okay. Next one. Aaron, another point.
Usually short in height.
Okay. Size. You are comparing the size. Usually short in size. Very good. Abhyuday.
When we can bend it easily.
Okay, we can bend it, bend the stem of it easily. Very good. And the last one, Emil.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, last and fourth point.
Ma'am.
Yes,
it's then. Like its stems are tender and green. And it's
okay, tender and green
stem.
Okay, okay. So these are the four points. Okay, now we can, I hope it is all clear. Now let me give some more examples for herbs. See, here you will get a list of examples of herbs. Tomato plant, wheat plant, rice plant, ginger, carrot, tulsi, and spinach. Palak is the Hindi word of it, spinach. And coriander. Coriander usually it is using at home in curries for to get some nice aroma. Coriander, pudina. Coriander in Hindi we call it dhania. And in pudina, yeah, the English word it is mint, mint leaf. Are you familiar with these all?
Yes.
Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
yes,
ma'am. You?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. If you are not familiar with this, just tell me, okay? So you should make a list of example for each type of herbs. Don't take only one or two example. Whenever you are writing example, you take at least four or five examples. Then the concept will be very clear to you. Okay, so herbs, example for herbs are tulsi, tomato, then paddy, yeah, wheat plant, rice plant, coriander. When it is in your home, you can see coriander leaves, coriander stem, how it is tender, very light.
Chilli is also a plant, right?
Ananda Krishnan?
Ma'am, chilli.
Yes, chilli is also there. Okay, chilli is also. But some type of chillies grow it like some more height. Some varieties of it. Okay, spinach. Spinach, then this rice plant, wheat plant, then coriander, grass. Grass, these all are example for which are growing near to the ground. They don't have any branch. Okay. So shall we move to the next one?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have any doubt?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay. So I think only 1 minute is left, right?
3:15, ma'am.
Okay, okay. That is why I got a confusion. That is why. Okay. So here we can move to the second group of plants. Okay. So they are called shrubs. In the picture itself, you can see the picture which it is shown there, it is not like the tulsi plant. It is growing much above the ground. Not near to the ground, much above, somewhat above the ground. And here you can see this plant, the stem is having some branches. And these branches are starting from the base itself. Some branches are starting from the base itself. Understood? So these type of plants are called shrubs. These type of plants are called shrubs. Okay. Taller. So first we are comparing the size. Taller than herbs but shorter than trees. Taller than herbs but shorter than trees. Ayan, where you are looking? And next one, about the branches. Stem branching out near the base or close to the ground. Stems branching out near the base or close to the ground. And the last one, about the character of the stem. It is hard but not very thick. It is hard but not very thick. Okay, so here I am going to mark the, highlight the main points. Taller than, it is about the size, taller than herbs, but shorter than trees. Branching out near to the base. Branching out near to the base or close to the ground. And the last point, stem is hard. Stem is hard, but not very thick. Is the stem of this plant is like the jackfruit tree?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay. So these Alchina, read the first point of the characteristics of these shrubs. Alchina, no, vanished. Malavika, yes, Malavika. Can you please read the first point, Malavika Bini? Malavika Bini, not hearing. So how you are attending the class then? Malavika, yes, Malavika. Can you hear me, Malavika? No response. So how she is hearing my, how she is attending the class then? Amita? Amita?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Amita. Read the first point.
Taller than herbs but shorter than trees.
Okay. Abhyuday, second point.
Branching out near the base.
Branching out near the base or close to the ground. Sri Rudra?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
The stem is hard but not very thick.
Stem is hard but not very thick. So, yes. So, let me ask you, Ayan, you are looking somewhere. All other family members are having their lunch. It's over now. It is 3 o'clock. Nearly is 3 o'clock. Why then? Say the first point. Ayan, say the first point.
Taller than shrubs.
Taller than
herbs.
Shorter
than.
Okay, somewhat you made it. Then next one, Ashish. Second point.
Ma'am, the stem is thick.
Okay, stem is thick. Is it thick? Stem is thick.
Not thick.
Okay. Hard but not thick. Stem is hard but not thick. And Sienna, the third point.
Branching out near the base or close to the
branching ground. Out near the base. Okay, stem is branching out near the base. So Ananda Krishnan, can you tell me that three characteristics of shrubs?
Shrubs are smaller than bigger than herbs, smaller than trees.
Okay.
Stems are hard but not thick.
Okay.
The branches are formed near the base.
Okay. Stem is branching out near the base. So Amita is also ready to say these 3 points. Yes, Amita, say the answer. 3 points of characteristics of shrubs.
Shorter, longer than bushes and shorter than trees.
Bushes. Did I say anything about bush? Bush is usually a shrub. Bushes are usually a shrub. Okay, listen properly. Ananya, help this Amita.
Ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes.
Ma'am, smaller than, bigger than shrubs. Smaller than trees.
Okay. Then?
Then branch comes from like in the base.
Okay. Stem is branching out near the base. Then? Then? Okay. 2 points I got. Now she is having some problems. Yes, Amita, tell me. You are not listening in the class. That is why you are not attentive to the class. That is why you can't. This is very simple. If you think simply, yes, Sri Rudra, tell me the point. Sri Rudra.
Ma'am, taller than stems. Taller than herbs, shorter than trees.
Okay. Amita, repeat it.
taller than herbs and shorter than trees.
Okay, Sri Rudra, second one.
Ma'am, branching out near the base.
Very good. Amita?
Branching out near the base.
Sri Rudra and the last one.
Ma'am, the branches are...
Not branches. Stem is hard, but not thick. Okay. Stem is hard, but not thick. So, Amita, write it two times. Okay. Write it two times. So these are the characteristics of shrubs. So here let me show you some more examples. Okay. Some more examples for this one. 1 minute. Write down the examples. Examples for shrubs. Okay, Arun, can you read the examples?
Jasmine. China yes. rose, lemon, Duranta,
Bougainvillea. Some of the examples of shrubs. See, not only these plants, you can find out so many examples. Okay, don't stick to these examples only. You can find your own brinjal plant. These all are some of the examples of shrubs. So jasmine, China rose, lemon, Duranta. Duranta is a type of flowering plant and also bougainvillea. Okay, so write down it. Up to that time, I will take the attendance. Aaron is
present. What?
Examples.
And what is China
rose? Duranta. Is it Duranta? It is a type of